What is up, everybody? Bootman here, and we are back with another Deadlock video. And the devs just hit us with a huge patch, and I wanted to break it down for you because there are a lot of changes, some small, some a bit bigger, so I want to go over them with you. All right, but before we get into that, if you're new here, hi, my name is Chris. I also go by Bootman, and yeah, I have been absolutely hooked on Deadlock. So if you are loving the game or you are trying to learn the game, make sure you subscribe and ring that notification bell. I'm making a ton of content, a bunch of guides. I'm also going to do news updates about patches and stuff like this, and you don't want to miss any of it. All right, so let's jump into this thing. If you're unaware, they post the updates for the game on their forum. If you're in the game, there's like a little prompt that comes up. I forgot where it is, but it says like, oh, do you want to join the Deadlock forums? Boom, this is where they post them, okay? I have transfer this over to a Google document because I wanted to highlight some things, because as you can see, it is fairly big. Okay, so I am going to go over some highlighted things, some things that I think are interesting or I think are important, but this thing is huge. Okay, so I will link the forum post down below, but I don't want this video to be like an hour long. It's probably going to be longer than I want already, so I'm just going to go over some of these. I don't even know if I'm going to go over all the things I highlighted. All right, so let's break it down real quick. All right, so they added a search to the public builds list now. Beautiful, love that. So those of you who don't know, when you are in the game, you can go to the shop, browse builds, and then if you go to public, boom, now we got a little search bar right there. So that's great. Nice little quality of life thing going on. All right, matchmaking window is now open 1 hour earlier. I absolutely love that. Anytime they're giving us more time to play, what more could you ask for? All right, players can now only pause once per game, and a team can only pause at most 3 times in total amongst all players. Beautiful. So I have never personally had a problem with people like uber trolling in the game with the pause, but I've seen stuff on like the Reddit and everything like that. So I'm glad they did this, because y'all know some trolls like to play video games. I know that might be a surprise to some of you, but yes, there are trolls in the online gaming space. All right, added the streamer setting to the options panel, causes players' names in the game UI panels to be hidden. So that's cool. I am not a large content creator or streamer by any means, but there are some bigger creators playing. Like I know Shroud's been playing a lot of Overwatch players like Seagull and stuff, they've been playing. So I'm sure they'll want to do this. There was a video, it's a very good video, and it was this other Deadlock creator, I can't remember his name, go search it. But anyways, he had a match against Shroud and he like broke it down, you know what I mean? And he had some things, like he like put in a clip of like Shroud like getting kind of tilted during the match and stuff. So like this is going to be helpful for the larger streamers who want to keep that hidden and maybe don't want like content created about them when they're like pubbing and like losing a match. So that's cool. All right, added a checkbox in the post game survey to make it not show again in the future. Lovely. All right, like if you've been playing Deadlock for a minute, it pops up at the end. It's like, how fun was the hero you played? How fun was the match you played? You know, and it's like, it's cool, but like not only do we have to do it at the end of literally every game, but they're probably getting massive amounts of these things coming through. So I'm glad this will take a little bit of that off our plate for both us and the developers. All right, so I just highlighted it, but spectating controls now use left right mouse buttons to switch between players on team and space to switch teams. This now works with free or cursor mode, and you can still click on portraits, minimap to spectate individual heroes. Like, I just want to highlight that. I don't know if this is good. I need to hop back in the spectator mode. I just wanted to highlight this because, for the love of God, if there are any Deadlock devs out there watching this, I know we're in playtest and it's probably at the bottom of the priority list, but please, 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 make the spectator mode, not the spectator mode, make the replay mode just a little bit better, a little bit more intuitive, the controls a little bit better. I am somebody who loves watching replays. I like love analyzing gameplay. I love learning. And like right now, like when you go watch replays, and I'm sure it's the same for like, you know, just regular spectating, it's just not great. It is pretty funky. I hope they keep working on this and improving it. Valve, if you're out there and you need somebody to go test this stuff and give suggestions, hit me up, all right? Like when I was in there, because I'll like take screenshots maybe for like thumbnails or whatever, and it is just, It is rough. It is rough. Okay, moving on. And moving on. Spending too much time on the controls. All right, this is something, this section, the miscellaneous gameplay, is probably something that you should all be paying attention to in case you zoned out at the beginning there. These are all huge, all right? So added wall jumping does not consume stamina, requires input direction away from the wall, can be done once. So this was not just super intuitive for me. I remember jumping in here and like trying forever to get it to work. And I was like, I don't know how this wall jump works, all right? Basically, if you hold the direction towards the wall and then you bounce off like that, see, you kind of spring backwards. You can also do it side to side, all right, but it does not use a stamina bar, so that's cool. So you can do it any direction, and you could do that. I haven't had a chance to use it in game, but I'm sure it adds a little bit more movement options to kind of mess with people and, you know, get away or, you know, just in the middle of a fight and stuff. I love the movement in this game. All right, moved flex slot from a set of enemy base guardians to all enemy lane guardians. So that's cool. So I believe that, you know, it is what it's saying. So like if, where's a map? All right, so right here. So now it's all in just one lane, I believe, rather than just the guardians just like straight across. So that is pretty cool. Added ropes to some buildings to let you climb up, hold jump key to latch onto them, can shoot while hanging from them. So yeah, this is kind of cool. You'll see these ropes. This is actually in the sandbox. So yeah, you just jump up and boop, slide down. You can go up like this. You can start shooting. You can start shooting people. Look at that. Look at that. So kind of cool. Kind of cool. I will say the one concern I do have is that they're like kind of having like feature creep, you know, like they just added these bounce pads around the map. Now they're adding these. I don't think it's like too cluttered right now, but it's definitely a concern that I have. So hopefully they know where the sweet spot is. All right, teleporters. A pair of teleporters has been added to the outer lanes at the midpoint near the three red neutral creeps. Four teleporters have changed locations. The upper floor teleporters have moved to the street level. The interior teleporters have moved to the bodega building. And the theater teleporters are now closed for the first 10 minutes. I'll be honest with you. I think I mentioned this in the beginner's guide, but I don't really use teleporters. I don't. I probably should, but I don't use them that much. So that's like, eh. Some more gameplay changes. Parry cooldown reduced. Something that I need to do more, especially like playing up against an Abrams. I don't parry much, but the cooldown has been reduced from 6 seconds to 5 seconds. Earn delivery sprint bonus +2 to +3. Love it. The minimum range the player must be to attack the walker is increased from 30 meters to 32 meters. So in the last patch, they upped this, like it was significant. I forget how much it was, but you could definitely feel how much further you had to be away from the walkers to actually hit them, which is like good and bad. Like if you're defending, it's great. If you're playing offensive, it's not great. But anyways, for some reason, they decided they need to up it a little bit more. Golden statues now drop rate increased by 6%. This is awesome. So something that if you're a newer player, something that I didn't start doing until way too late in the game was finding these statues and hitting them. So those of you who don't know, there's these little statues around the map, and those ones didn't have any. So no 6% here. But yeah, they have stats bonuses in them. Stats bonuses in them. So yeah, like you just, you know, keep finding these like throughout the map and just, yeah, they boost your stats. It's great. So this is something that I've gotten much better at, and you could definitely feel it. You could definitely feel it. So make sure you're looking for these because they just up the drop rate. All right, so they replaced some bounce pads with ropes. They added 2 bounce pads, added a bounce pad from the Amber Orange Sandfire. So yeah, this looks like it's like near the walkers, and it gives you a boost forward. So if you're trying to retake that area, beautiful. All right, several buildings have been made taller so you can't get on top of them, and several buildings have been made shorter so you can get on top of them. I did notice this. I only played a couple games after the patch, but I did notice these buildings and getting on top of them. It's pretty cool. And a few of the buildings have new passageways and higher floors. All right, weapon items. So at first I was sad about this. I mentioned this in my Kelvin, how to play Kelvin video. Make sure you go watch that. If you're interested in learning more about Kelvin, let me know down in the comments if there are any other heroes that you want me to go over. But anyways, this was a very underrated item and I was like super bummed. I'm like, wait, you just reduced it? You just nerfed my brand new toy? But now has an upgrade. So we'll go over that in a second. Active reload. This is an item that I just started using a lot more of. It speeds up your reload, but also gives you like lifesteal. Well, they just reduced the lifesteal from 30% to 22%, which is kind of cool. Like some people were very, very good with this. And yeah, so that's great. Buff duration also reduced. So that got hit with a pretty big nerf. And again, I will link the full forum post down below. I'm sure there's some of these items that you care more about than I do, so make sure you go check out the full post. Melee charge now grants +1 HP regen. Not sure if that's needed. That's usually on Abrams likes to use this item and he's already very tanky. Titanic magazine bullet armor increased. I enjoy that. I am an Ivy player and I get a lot of Titanic magazine. It's an excellent item. Excellent, excellent. Intensifying magazine now steadily ramps back down to 0% when you stop shooting rather than instantly emptying. Very good. Alchemical fire, cooldown reduced from 28 seconds to 26 seconds. So make sure if you're not, make sure you're subscribed, because I am going to make a video very soon about Deadlock websites for like stats. There are some very, very good ones, and this is all coming back to Alchemic Fire, or Alchemical, how do you say that? Alchemical Fire? Anyways, it's coming back to that. But anyways, I will be making a video on that. There are very, very useful sites if you are a stats nerd like me, if you like to see builds and stuff. So I will be making a video on that very soon. And anyways, what I'm getting at, I've been looking at a lot of high MMR players, and a lot of them, use this item. So I am planning on working into some of my builds. So it's kind of cool to see it got a slight little buff. All right, so high velocity mag. This is the new upgraded item. Add a new T3 weapon item. Headhunter requires, it requires a high velocity mag. It grants 50% bullet velocity, love it. 15% weapon damage, and 150 bullet shield. Passive cooldown. Landing a headshot on heroes deals bonus +140 damage, heals you for 8% max HP, and grants +2 meters per second for 3 seconds. Cooldown, 6 seconds. Awesome. Now, the only thing is, the heroes I use high velocity mag on, like Kelvin or maybe like Viscus, and like I think Warden, I like to get it. Like the thing is, I usually just get the high velocity mag for like early game for harass, you know, so I can, you know, have a little bit of distance and my shots are a little bit more accurate. But this is a T3 item, so it seems like it'll be better late game, but it's just I don't shoot as much. Well, with Kelvin, I think it might be a really, really good item on Warden, but we'll see how players utilize this. All right, siphon bullets, weapon damage reduced from 40% to 28%. Massive, massive nerf. Lucky shot proc chance increased from 30% to 35%. Don't know if that's necessary. Heroes like Haze get that. Not sure if we needed that. Ricochet bounce damage increase. Again, that is like a Haze item. Not sure if we needed that. Vitality items. Going back to what I was saying about items that I've seen a lot of high MMR players using, this is definitely one of them. It's one I'm going to start playing around with on Kelvin, but it looks like they just nerfed a little bit of it, gave a little bit of a buff, so I don't really have many thoughts or opinions because I haven't used it much. Leech no longer has 30% heal reduction resist, so a little bit of nerf on that. They buffed Unstoppable, and let me say this, dude. So, Seven is a controversial hero, in my opinion. He's very good. He's very good for like low-level players, medium players, and maybe even above average players. Once you get into very high MMR, Seven is not great, all right? But anyways, stuff like this really, really, really helps out Seven and some other heroes. So we'll see how many people are using Unstoppable. Don't know how I feel about that one. Spirit items. Quicksilver no longer has 10% plus 10% reload time, suppressor health regen reduced from 3 to 2.5. These are two other items that like carry high DPS players or heroes like Haze use. So a little bit of nerf on that, and that's good because we just got, you know, some buffs from these items over here. So that's cool. Curse duration reduced from 3.25. Not sure how I feel about that. Usually this is like an item used to like stop somebody like seven, but I've been using curse, I've been using knockdown just for more CC, and yeah, so we'll see how it feels. That's not like, this isn't a huge reduction, but we'll see if it's noticeable. Magic carpet, so this is a brand new item they put in the last patch, and let me tell you everybody this. I don't think I've seen a single person in any match that I've played for the last 2 weeks or so since they did the last patch. I don't think I've seen anybody use magical carpet. So hopefully this gets the item a little bit more usage. So Abrams, now we're at the hero changes. So Abrams, infernal resilience regeneration time increased from 16 seconds to 18 seconds. Parentheses, this is a nerf. So from what I understand, okay, it gives you some regen over time. So increasing this by 2 seconds makes it so you're getting less heal because it's spread out over a longer duration. So that's why it's a nerf. This right here, if you want to let me know in the comments below, I have no idea what this means. Now does pull-ups on the zip line once again. All right, let's hop in the sandbox. Let's hop in the sandbox and see what that is. Wait, is this guy? He's doing pull-ups. Okay. In the patch notes, it says this is a buff. Like, is that just like a fun pun? Is that like supposed to be punny that it's a buff because he's getting buff as he does pull-ups? All right. Some dynamo changes. So gun damage reduced from 15 to 13. Interesting. Dynamo's definitely more of a high-level player. I think, you know, just like on an overall tier list, like I don't think the majority of players are great with him, but he is a good character. He kind of reminds me a little of like, his ult is kind of like Black Hole from like Dota, a little Tidehunter-y even. But yeah, so he is powerful, but I don't see a lot of people do very well with him. A lot of people feed because, you know, you pull people in and then you're just kind of there. But anyways, it reduces gun damage. His gun did do a lot of damage early game. Singularity cast time increased and the range reduced. So he got hit with some nerfs. Gray Talon. So charge shot collision size reduced by 8%. Fantastic. The hitbox on that thing was massive. All right. So also they reduced the damage. They reduced charge shot tier 2 reduced from 70 to 65. The immobilizing trap, some interesting changes here. The root duration is reduced, but now the trap also applies a 50% movement slow for 1 second after the root. And then the immobilizing trap tier 2 changed from a 1 second root to a 2 second slow. All right, so it'll be interesting. I don't play Gray Talon, but I do get caught up in Gray Talon traps, so we'll see how that goes. Haze, base bullet damage increased from 5.3 to 5.6. Not sure why that was needed. Sleep dagger cooldown reduced from 27 seconds to 25 seconds. I am kind of glad about that. I do play a little bit of Haze, and yeah, like it seems like the dagger cooldown is just way too long. So hopefully this feels a little bit better. All right, some Infernus changes. They didn't seem too big, but again, if you want to check out the patch notes, go for it. Ivy no longer silences allies. It also now causes allies to deal 50% less damage while being carried. The movement adjusted to be a little less frantic. I'm curious to see how that feels. All right, let's see. Is it less frantic? All right. So also, if you could see, they also gave you the ability to move up and down. This is cool. I didn't even realize you could change like the height of it until like yesterday. So I was aiming. I figured out you could aim, but now this is kind of cool that you can kind of just use shift and control to move up and down. So that's nice. That's a nice little quality of life thing. All right, so self-cast time increased. I'm on the fence about that. It already felt like it took way too long to get up in the air if you self-cast. Move speed reduced slightly. Airdrop flight, you can pitch up and down. I just showed you that. All right, Kelvin, my man. So bullet radius increase, love that. Larger hitbox. Base health growth per boon increase from plus 45 to 50, love that. Arctic beam max slow increase from 60% to 80%, love it even more. Arctic beam now affects soul orbs, secures slash denies them. So this is awesome as well. So in case you didn't know, you could not get like souls when you were using the ice beam. But look at that. So like it would leave you in weird situations because you would be on a lane and maybe like early game harassing on the lane and you'd be like shooting at an enemy, they'd run, and you're like, okay, well I'll just, you know, spend my ice beam on these creeps. Well now you can actually get the orbs too, because the orbs would just float up, and then if they were, you know, if they could, they would just deny them, and you're just sitting here with your beam out, and you're like, okay, do I cancel it and start, you know, shooting the orbs, and also, you know, put myself at risk for them to pop back up. So I'm kind of glad about that. Arctic beam tier 3 range reduced from 15 to 13. Not a huge deal. You're usually getting like the increased reach item, so that's not a big deal to me. Grenade heal increase from 135 to 145. Love that. Lash, this feels like it's huge. This feels like probably one of the biggest changes in the game. I don't know yet. I don't play Lash. I play against a lot of Lashes. I haven't faced one yet, so I'm curious to see. The grapple no longer gives a stamina charge on use. All right, so Lash has an insane amount of mobility, so this might be big. We'll see how it goes. So 7, Cloud Spirit power scaling reduced from 1.1 to 0.8. Love that. Storm cloud time to reach maximum radius reduced from 6 seconds to 3 seconds. Thanks, I hate it. I absolutely hate it. So his ult is going to get a max size in half the time. What? Like that's rough. Storm cloud now provides plus 20% bullet resistance in the base ability. So yeah, this is all insane. This is insane. All right, this, whatever, cool. Thanks for nerfing it a little, but this is crazy to me. I think that 7 has one of the most overpowered alts. There are ways to counter it. Somebody even made a video recently on like how to counter 7, but yeah, his alt is ridiculous, and I don't have enough time in this video to fully complain about it, but it's insane. All right, so Shiv. Shiv got hit with a bunch of nerfs. All right, that's all you need to know. Shiv got hit with a bunch of nerfs. I think the last set of nerfs were fine, and he was like more reasonable, but he just got hit with more nerfs, so I don't know. I guess our internal metrics showed he was still strong. So Viscus now has an alt fire that has limited range but deals AoE damage that cannot headshot. So I believe aside from Shiv, Viscus is the only other one who has an alternate fire. So check it out. Blunk, blunk, blunk. So 70 damage. A regular bullet does 26. So yeah, you're doing like 2.5 times ish with this alt fire. And it has a little bit of AoE. Let's see if we could try that on maybe some creeps. Maybe some creeps. Oh wow, the range on that is awful. It is awful. If we look right here, a little AoE damage. So that's cool. I like that. So yeah, he no longer has like aim down sight. He just has this kind of little AoE. Look at that. So that's fun. We'll see how that goes. All right, so lastly, Warden's base movement speed was reduced from 6.5 to 6, which, yeah, okay, cool. Warden is very, very, very strong. I am surprised he didn't get hit with more nerfs, but hey, you know, whatever, this works. All right, but anyways, yeah, thanks for watching and going over these patch notes. This was huge. I've been around for maybe like 3 weeks now, and word on the street is that they do huge patches like this every 2 weeks or so. So anyways, make sure you subscribe and ring that notification bell so you don't miss any news, updates, all that important stuff. And again, I will link the full patch notes down below if you wanna check out everything. All right, but anyways, that's all I got for this video. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you're new, subscribe, ring that notification bell, and have an amazing rest of your day. I'll see you in the next one.